today we have a really special sponsor stream from Microsoft. And so thank you to the Azure team. We're going to build an app completely from scratch, a Node.js app, and then we'll deploy it to Azure, deploy it to the cloud. And then we're going to put it onto like Kubernetes and put it onto Azure. And I'll show you how to do all of that without even needing to have Docker on your computer or anything. It's going to be really cool. But first off, I guess we're going to create a repository for our project. It's going to be a very, very simple app. So this is going to be a Christmas countdown. We're going to have a public repository, and it's going to do Christmas countdown. Node.js app. And we'll add a readme, add a gitignore, and the gitignore is going to be a node app. And then I can create repository. Let's initialize the Christmas countdown. Okay, Christmas countdown, whatever you want. That's fine. And Christmas countdown app for Node.js. And enter point, yes, test command, get repository, keywords. We'll say Christmas countdown Node.js JavaScript and Instafluff. Wait, and then other Instafluff, and IT license. Wait, yes. I wish I had Nano so that, because what I like to do on Nano is then I just do a Nano thing and then I'm like, web, and then like run, blah, 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 and then that's all I need to create for it. Except in here, what I'm gonna do is I actually want to have an API for it. So be like web.apis. Let's say countdown body and options. We need to have the timer. We need to know how much time there is between now and Christmas, and then return that in the API. So what I wanna know is, Christmas is da da da. So I want to find JavaScript date. Here we go. Get the this is perfect. This is what we needed. Hiya! December 25th, 2021. Hiya. And there we go. There's Christmas. And then we have today is just this, right? Well, I just need to return this. And so I'm gonna return it as a JSON object and be like Christmas. Actually, I can just return this. And then today, time until is gonna be diff. Run this on port 8080, why not? Localhost 8080 and then countdown should give us, whoa, it's tiny. Time until is, I think this is in milliseconds. I think what I'm gonna do is actually, I'm gonna compute this. So time until, and then I'm gonna do milliseconds is diff, and then time until in seconds is gonna be diff divided by 1000, and time until in minutes is going to be just divided by 60,000. 60 minutes times 60 seconds. Time until days is gonna be diff, and then it's gonna be 24. Times 60 times 60,000, and that should be it. Well, bam! Oh yeah! Now we have time to milliseconds, and so we have 42 days until. Oh yeah, actually, I should center horizontally though. Let me do that. To center horizontally, you're gonna be like, well, that equals 100%. You say text align, and then you go center, center, and then, well, bam! Ooh, check it out! Would you look at that? The inner text is gonna be, I'm gonna do this. Cop, bam. How, what is it? Is it two fixed? Two? I forgot to close it. Yeah, 42.54 days. Days until Christmas. Hiya. And so now, ooh. And I can set the font size on this to be something ridiculously big, 128. Whoa. So when we do minutes, dip minus. And be like minus days times, it's gonna be days times, days times 60, because it's 60 minutes, remove that. And then we have seconds is gonna be equal to, but without the 60, days times 60 times 60 plus mins times 60. And so now we can format this. We can be like 42 days, something, something hours, etc., etc., until Christmas. So then, down. Hours and then we have minutes, and then we have seconds, and then milliseconds. I call it mills. Hi-ya! 42 days, 12 hours, 37 minutes, 52 seconds, and 937 milliseconds until Christmas. Maybe what I'll do though, I should do this as a timer. Command, set interval, command, and then this, and then go like this. I guess this is good enough for now. With that, now we have this app. We have it, it works, and it's here, and now all we gotta do is to get it onto Azure Kubernetes. So I'm gonna log into portal Azure, Here, what I have to do is I have to find DevOps. Create a cluster, let's do it. So here we go, this is fine. And then I will put this on, yeah, on Instafluff, that's fine. Standard, Christmas countdown. So resource group, what is this? Actually, I should create a new resource group because then it'll make it really easy for me to delete it. So I'll call this Christmas countdown. As a resource group. Christmas countdown. It's created. Deployment in progress. Ah! Now we're gonna connect this to Azure Pipelines. It's pretty easy, it's pretty nice. So you just do start free or start GitHub, and then even the pricing, there's the free pricing as you saw earlier, free for open source projects. Start free, over it. Command. Let's go, yeah, signed in. I guess that works. Okay, S-M-D-Y-K-K-D. Continue. Ooh, Polly, you got it working. Check this out. 42 days, 12 hours, 25 minutes, 8 seconds until Christmas. This is what we're gonna do. Build and push the image to Azure Container Registry deployed to Azure Kubernetes Service. So, let me see if I have signed in. I think I've signed in this and signed into account. And yeah, namespace Christmas countdown. Everything I'm just calling Christmas countdown. Container registries. And then we'll create one. And then there you go, resource group is gonna be Christmas countdown, and then enter the name. This is Christmas countdown everything. Create. The pipeline is instafluff.christmascountdown. And then, yeah, show more information. Okay, so here it is, project settings. And then new pipeline. And we're gonna select GitHub. And then we select our repository. We're gonna select Christmas countdown. And then configure the pipeline. Yeah, okay. And then more actions. Yeah, this is fine. Review. It has all the things. And then we'll do run. And then it creates the pipeline. There isn't much that it has to do. It just needs to create this pipeline and then that's it. Manually run. Stages. Build stage. And it's queued. It might be working. It might be doing something. I think that's all I have to do. I just had to create a new one. It wants a Docker file. Okay, so we might have to create our own Docker file, but once we do that, then it should be fine. And so the Docker file is gonna be on the main thing here. I'm gonna find a template Docker file that we could use. I think that's gonna be easy, right? Here's one, super easy. Let's put it in there and packages then, yeah. And then I install TypeScript latest. We don't even really need TypeScript, do we? Yeah, we don't need that. And then only production, and then npm start expose 8080 because we run it on 8080, port 8080. Copy everything from that, and ba-bam. Okay, we're gonna... Now we did that. So then, and then it picks it up. But we're about to put it onto cloud here. And we just put in the Docker file, so now it's building, and we can see it in progress, and then we'll see what's going on. And here it is, and it says deploying, and da-da-da, and it's building. So it's gonna build, and then deploy, and then do the pull request, and hopefully that should be it. And then it just does this. It's just like, you don't have, like, I don't have Docker installed on my computer. You don't need to do, like, any sort of, like, build image building things or anything on your own computer or locally. You just set the thing up and you're like, point it to this repository and then check in my Docker file. And there you have it. But it's deploying. It's deploying to the Kubernetes cluster and did the thing and then it's created it and it deployed. Finalized. It finished. Wait a minute. That means if I go to environments, do you know what this means? It's running. What? We did it just like that. And this is cool. This is dang cool, right? Because we went from our local Christmas countdown server thing that's running on port 8080 on this computer here on localhost, and then we just use the Microsoft Azure portal to then create a Kubernetes cluster and a container registry. We went here and went to the Azure DevOps and then created a new pipeline that connected to our GitHub repository, and then it just automatically picked it up and configured all the settings to connect up to the Kubernetes cluster. I can't believe it works. It's so cool. So there you have it, folks. That's all you gotta do to do Kubernetes on the cloud.